ground, there was a footprint. A big footprint. So I was hooked from that moment on. I started spending all the time I could spare searching for the beast, then I spent time I couldn't spare. That's how I lost my job and my friends.
So sad.
Well, I didn't tell it so you could cry in your sprouts or whatever that is, darling. I'm telling it so that your father won't make the same mistake.
Well, I appreciate what you're saying, Dr. Wrightwood, but there's a big difference between your story and mine.
Not as big as you think.
Maybe even bigger.
No, you're kidding yourself. I remember what you told me when you came into my shop. Bigfoot can come live with us. We'll accept the responsibility. Can you imagine what a Bigfoot would do to your home? Yeah, well, I can. You're good people. I'm gonna say this once. I'm gonna say it's simple. And I hope to God, for your sakes, you all listen. There are no abominable snowmen. There are no Sasquatches. There are no Bigfeet. Am I missing something? Oh, Lord. Lord God.
Dr. Wrightwood, say hello to Harry.
Hello.
Something?
Oh, yes, he's so smart, too. I mean, George has taught him how to sit.
To sit?
We haven't quite perfected it yet.
Hungry?
He lives here with you?
Temporarily.
Favor, I might be able to get you out sometime tonight.
Sometime tonight?
I need a reason.
For Christ's sake, I'm talking about bagging a Sasquatch!
That'll cut a lot of ice with the judge.